What's up? Before we get started, I just want to give a special thanks and shout outs to Ableton for sponsoring this video. My name is Michael Weston, and today I want to go over the new auto warping improvements that are now available in Ableton Live 11.3. Coming from the hip-hop world, sampling is vital. It is the language, it is the backbone of the genre that I love so much. And Ableton has really become that tool for me that has allowed me to find my own creative DNA. And warping is really that key signature thing that has helped me to grow as a producer in the genre. So I've made many sampling and warping tutorials on my channel thus far, and even in my cook-up videos where I'm just making music from scratch, one thing is always apparent: auto warping is an awesome feature, but it still required a lot of manpower, a lot of warp marks. So the good people at Ableton, they answered the call and they doubled down. And 11.3, I believe that they solved this issue. And now I can confidently say that the auto warping features in Ableton is a heck of a lot better. And you guys are gonna notice now going forward that less warp markers are needed. Okay, so let's check out these new Live 11 release notes, 11.3.2 release notes, auto warp improvements. Live now uses a new auto warp algorithm. Both downbeat and tempo variations are more accurately analyzed, making it possible to work with longer samples and entire songs without the need for manual warping in most cases. To run the new auto warp algorithm on clips within an existing live set, use any of the warp from here commands found in the sample editor's context menu from any location in a clip. Okay, so here's my sample right here. You're gonna notice that in the beginning of the sample, the metronome sounds and feels like it's already locked in. But about halfway through the sample, we're gonna start to hear and feel that the sample is not perfectly locked in with the metronome. Okay, cool. So you guys can hear and feel that it sounds like, even without this sample being warped, as you can see, there is no, the warp button is not turned on, but I'm gonna go ahead and play the sample from here, and you can hear and feel that the sample is not in perfect time. Let me just go ahead and do what the Ableton Live notes said. So I'm gonna turn on warp, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click and I'm gonna choose the warp, any of these warp from here options. And we're gonna see what happens. Okay, let me fast forward it. It sounds great. Let me fast forward to that treble region. Just to recap, I didn't do anything other than just turn on warp and choose a warp from here option. So let's drag another sample in. Let's find a nice little drum break, something that can match the vibe of this sample. And let's see how the auto warp feature works with that too. I should honestly just be able to just drag it in, honestly, and it's probably gonna just lock in perfectly with the tempo. Just as I expected, it sounds phenomenal. Everything is linked up perfectly tempo-wise. I love it. So the new update it responds really intuitively to downbeats and tempo changes. And I hear that. And I did no work. And this is a full sample. What we're going to notice now moving forward with Ableton Live 11.3 is that full samples, full songs are going to respond way better than they used to the auto-warping feature. It's going to be less work on us, less warp markers that we would need to manually put in. All recorded audio will also respond the same way to this auto-warping feature. So when you plug in your guitar, when you're recording vocals, and you're chopping things up, you're going to notice that the auto-warp feature also responds very well to that as well. Dang, man, there's literally nothing else to do but to like make a dope beat now. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to use this same melody. What I want to do is drag this melody into a sampler, chop it up, have fun with it. If you made it this far through the video, I just want to say thank you so much for rocking with the content. Shout out to Ableton for the amazing new update to an already amazing software. And before we go, I just want to say stay encouraged, keep making music. My name is Michael Weston, and I'm out.